Hello, welcome viewers to Elimu TV, whereby we are going to learn and experience together. We are going to have our Biology Form 2, Lesson 3, whereby your tutor will be Mr. Gerald. We are going to handle the topic on transporting plants under the subtopic absorption of water and mineral salts. And as you are aware that plants, they need water and mineral salts, so we are going to look at the structures which are responsible for the absorption of the same, that is, water and mineral salts. Welcome. We should have the following lesson goal, whereby by the end of the lesson, we should be able to explain the process through which water and mineral salts are absorbed by the root S. So you should be very keen as we are doing the lesson. The first thing that we are going to look at, before the absorption of the water, it is also good that we look at the importance of the water in the plants, that is the role it will play in the same plants, whereby we can say the first importance of water is for growth and development, whereby water plays an important role in a plant growth and development, because this one is water is needed in the cells of the plant for their growth. Our second importance of water, we can say that water, it is a raw material for photosynthesis, a medium of transport and metabolic reactions. That importance of water is that water acts as a solute in a plant body, and it also provides mechanical support, because when plant cells are touching, they are firm and rigid. Our last importance of water, I say that it has a cooling effect to the plant body due to its higher latent heat of vaporization. This one can be explained in terms of when the external environment of the plant is very high, all the heat is high due to the latent heat of vaporization. It cools the internal cells of the plant. Now we are going to deal with the real absorption now of water from the roots, whereby, as you can see from our diagram, the absorption of water is normally done by the root S. As you can see from the far left hand, we have the root S, which have gone deep down into the soil particles, and in the soil particles is whereby we are getting the film of water. So water, it enters the root S by osmosis, as you can see from our diagram. So once it gets there, now due to other forces which shall come for them at later lessons, it goes up to the plant. So we can say water is drawn into the root air cells by osmosis. Due to the presence of dissolved substances in the cell sap of the root air, the concentration of the cell sap is greater than that of the surrounding solution in the soil. A concentration gradient therefore exists between the sap in the vacuole of the root air cell and the soil water. This exerts a high osmotic pressure, thus drawing the water molecules across the cell membrane to the root air cells. The osmotic pressure exerted by the root air cells overcomes the water retaining powers of the soil, thereby enabling water in the soil to enter the root. More water drawn into the root air cells dilute the cell sap, making it less concentrated than that in the adjacent cortex cell of the root, as you can see from our diagram. Due to osmotic gradient, the water moves from the adjacent cell to the next by osmosis. Similarly, water passes through the successive cortex cells until it enters the xylem vessels located in the center of the root. These xylem vessels of the root then conduct the water into the xylem vessels of the stem and into the xylem vessels of the leaves. So generally, water transports, it is transmitted through the xylem vessels, either the one from the roots or the stem up to the leaves. That is about the absorption of water. And now we are going to have the uptake of minerals. Though most of the minerals, they are contained in the water, but we can have a diagram to represent the absorption of mineral salts, whereby we can say the soil water contains dissolved mineral salts, which plants require for their growth and proper functioning. They must therefore be absorbed from the soil into the plant. Generally, the concentration of the cell sap in the root air is greater than that in the soil. The mineral ions therefore enter the root air against the concentration gradient. This suggests that salts can be drawn from the soil even if their concentration in the soil is lower than that in the nutrient cells. This process uses energy and is referred to as active transport. Mineral ions, whose concentration is higher in the soil solution than the root air cells, take up by diffusion. Like you can see from our diagram, the mineral ions, after absorption, they move through the root cells into the xylem vessels of the vascular tissue in the root. Once inside these vessels, the ions and water are carried up the stem into the leaf by a combination of cell processes, whereby the processes may include osmosis, diffusion, and capillary action. And that is how the mineral salts are able to be transported up to the leaves. Having done and said that, you can have the following activity, whereby you are required to draw and explain how water is absorbed from the soil until it reaches the leaves of a plant. Here you are required to explain the process that we have explained in our lesson. For more reference on this lesson, you can refer to KLB, Secondary Biology Students Book 1, 4th edition, Kenya Literature Bureau. And for more of this in lessons, you can contact us by sending us an SMS through the number that is appearing on our screen, or you subscribe to our YouTube channel, which is Elimu TV, or you send us a message on our Facebook page, which is also Elimu TV, or you subscribe to our Twitter page and send us a message at Elimu_Kenya. Thank you for watching, and let us interact more on these channels for more lessons. Thank you.